here at Golden Gate State Park, and I'm really excited to be here. We've done a lot of work around supporting our state parks in Colorado, including next year we're reducing the cost of an annual state park pass from $84 a year to $29 a year. So it's going to be a lot more affordable for families to access everything that our state parks have to offer. We're really excited about that. Did I get the price right, Tim? Okay, just want to make sure. We also added two new state parks, Sweetwater Lake State Park, west of here, and in southern Colorado, Fisher's Peak. You know, in 2007, our state added a new state song, Rocky Mountain High. And this year is the 50th anniversary of the original release of Rocky Mountain High. And we thought, as a fitting tribute from our state, we would rename one of our most beautiful trails here at Golden Gate State Park as the Rocky Mountain High Trail. And we're excited to make that announcement here today. You know, I didn't mention this, Zach, but my very first concert was Red Rocks 1980, John Denver. I was 5 years old. So my parents took me. That was my very first concert. I was dancing in the aisles and grew up, of course, as many Coloradans do, with a great love of John Denver and the way his music really celebrated our way of life in Colorado, embodied our way of life in Colorado, our majestic mountains, our bright blue skies, our starlit nights, our forests and streams. And those world-famous lyrics from Rocky Mountain High have really helped establish what Colorado is and aspires to be, not only in our minds, but in the minds of people all over the world. And many of them, of course, also visit Colorado and support jobs in our tourism and recreation industry. So I'm proud of the work we've done to really make this vision of reality of preserving great opportunities for access to the outdoors, reducing costs, expanding access at several of our state parks. We now have heavy-duty wheelchairs that enable people with disabilities to enjoy and go on hikes with the rest of their families. You know, the work never ends. And, of course, in John's honor, we push forward. And to commemorate both the 50th anniversary of the song and John's commitment to protecting our environment and being good stewards, I'm thrilled to announce that we're renaming Mountain Lion Trail in Golden Gate State Park to Rocky Mountain High Trail. You know, we have such a great affinity for the outdoors in our state, and we celebrate the outdoors, and we want to see that enthusiasm in every corner of our state. It's healthy to be outdoors. It's healthy physically and spiritually and emotionally, and we're excited that in record numbers, Coloradans are enjoying our great outdoors, and we know that as everybody takes a hike on the Rocky Mountain High Trail here at Golden Gate State Park, they'll be humming along the way. Colorado, Rocky Mountain High. Thank you to everybody for being here. With that, I'm going to turn it over to my good friend and guru, Chuck.
Thank you very much. I was honored that they asked. I knew John a long time, mostly because I got to be friendly with him because I managed the Dirt Band, Nitty Gritty Dirt Band, for years. They're still my best friends, and they all lived in Aspen in the old days, and John, of course, lived up there. So I became really good friends with John because of that, through the Dirt Band, and we remain great friends. I guess my best experience is we did an album, the Dirt Band, that I was executive producer on, called Will the Circle Be Unbroken, Volume 2, and I called John to see if he'd like to sing on it. And, of course, he said absolutely, flew his plane down in Nashville. I stood there while he sang with the Dirt Band on Circle 2, which won 4 Grammys. And that was a great experience. And if I remember, the song was And So It Goes, written by my buddy Don Schlitz, who's a great songwriter. And John was so great. He was just a wonderful guy, so approachable. So he's just a very special person. And we all miss him. And thank you for letting me say a few words.
Amy Abrams manages the estate. I don't know if it's too presumptuous to say Jazak. I hope it's not an Amy, but I think John would have really appreciated this partnership. I think he'd be very excited about it.
Absolutely.
I didn't know him personally. I met him, but I didn't know him personally. But I think from everything I know about him, he would be very excited about this partnership with the state of Colorado. Amy Abrams.
Thank you, Governor Polis, and thanks to Chuck Morris and the team at Colorado Parks and Wildlife. On behalf of John's estate and family, we're really honored and excited about this trail naming. I wrote temporary, but I can change it to permanent trail naming here at Golden Gate Canyon State Park, and appreciate all of you here today. John was drawn to the Rocky Mountains as a young man and made Colorado his home. We're so fortunate to have community and representatives here in Colorado who value both music and natural spaces, and there's nothing better than when they come together. 50 years ago this summer, John went camping in the Rocky Mountains with some friends to watch the Perseid meteor shower, and he wrote of that experience in the song Rocky Mountain High, with lyrics expressing the love and wonder he felt for his adopted state of Colorado, which is often referenced as an inspiration for visitors to the state from around the world. The song was a top 10 hit for John in 1972 and was officially recognized as Colorado's second state song in March of 2007. And I know personally, when I'm driving on a mountain road like the ones coming up here to the park, that song always comes to mind. In the early 70s, John was one of the first artists to share an environmental message through his music, and fans responded. He understood that responsibility came with having a public voice and contributed his talents to the benefit and charitable and environmental cases around the world, especially here in Colorado. One of his greatest pleasures was spending time outdoors. And he, of course, found inspiration for his music in the outdoors. Throughout his life, John worked to preserve natural spaces and ensure that everyone would have access to these places that brought him so much joy. This year, for the 50th anniversary of the song and album, Rocky Mountain High, John Denver's estate celebrates with many initiatives starting here at home in Colorado, including teaming up with the Colorado Symphony Orchestra for a tribute to the Rocky Mountain High album, September 8th. We're honored by the trail naming here in Golden Gate Canyon State Park and encourage folks to visit this summer, enjoy the natural spaces Colorado has to offer, and find a bit of that Rocky Mountain High for yourself. Thank you.
Thank you. Rocky Mountain High Trail here at Golden Gate State Park.
Thank you, Amy.